Hello students, welcome to my channel. With continuation of video lecture series on farm machinery, this video lecture is on cost analysis of tractor and implements. Farm power, machinery and equipments are major cost item in agriculture. Large machines, new technology, high price of parts and new machinery and higher energy cost has caused a lot of problem for the farmers. However, good management skill of the farmers can reduce the cost of the operation by around 10,000 per hectare. All of these decisions requires accurate estimation of the cost of owning the machine as well as taking on the higher basis. Coming to the machinery cost, farm machinery cost can be divided into two categories. One is the fixed cost or ownership cost and another is the operating cost or variable cost. Fixed cost, which occurs regardless of the machine use, and operating costs, which vary directly with the amount of machine used. The true value of the sum of these costs is not known until the machine is sold or worn out. But the cost can be estimated by making a few assumptions about machine life, annual use, and fuel and labor costs. Coming to the ownership cost or fixed cost, depreciation is one of the costs resulting from wear, obsolescence, and age of machine. The degree of mechanical wear may cause the value of the particular machine to be reduced, but value for similar machine when it is traded or sold. The introduction of new technology or major design change may also cause the obsolescence of the existing machines. Therefore, an estimation of annual depreciation can be calculated. An economic life for the machine and salvage value at the end of the economic life must be specified. The economic life of a machine is the number of years for which costs are to be estimated. It is often less than the machine's service year, life year, because farmers trade a machine for different one before it is completely worn out. Basically, coming to the depreciation, so there are different methods to calculate the depreciation value, which actually it's reduced each year, which can be calculated by straight line method, where actually if you know that D is the depreciation cost on that year, each year, where P is the you can say depreciation cost rupees per year can be calculated as, if you know the purchase price in rupees and salvage value of the machine, it is 10% of the purchase price in rupees. This is also rupees, and L is the economic machine life in year. Then we can calculate the straight line method, depreciation value will be a cost will be equal to P minus S into L, or we can calculate it the value in rupees per hour. So if we know the H, which is the working hour per year. Coming to the second method, that is declining balance method, each year the depreciation value is reduced actually. So let us see, D n plus 1 is the amount of depreciation or depreciation cost for the year n plus 1. That is rupees per year will be equal to value in the n year minus value of the n plus 1 year, next year. So that is, let us, n is the age of the machine in the year, at the beginning of the year in the question. That is, and also Vn is the depreciation value after n years, and Vn plus the depreciation value after n plus 1 year. So this year minus next, so next year. That is the depreciation cost for that year. So, or it can also be calculated with the value of X. That is, if we knew the P, the purchase price in rupees, and L is the economic machine life in year, X is the rate of depreciation value, that is either 1, this one can be 1 or 2, generally depending on the condition. 2 for the double declining balance method, and 1 is generally used, and 1.5 is generally used for the used machines. New machines, generally 1 is used. Most cases actually 2 is used, very rare cases 2 is used. Coming to the third method, that is sum of the year digit method. Here actually, if n is the year, next year, what are the depreciation cost, then dn plus 1 is the amount of depreciation charge for the year, n plus 1. So, and L is the economic machine life in year, and yd is the sum of year digit method. So, let us see, 10 is the n, total life, L is the 10, and n is 2. Then, yd will be equal to, generally, 10 into 11 by 2. That is L into L plus 1 by 2, that is 55. And if you find out Dn plus 1, then that will be L minus N, L is 10 minus 2, that is 8 divided by 55 into P minus S. That is the dN plus 1 in this case. That is the third year, the cost will be 8 by 55 into P minus S. And L is the age of the machine, P is the purchase price, already known. S is the salvage value. This is the method, that is rupees per year. And if you want to find out the rupees per hour, then you have to divide by annual use in hour. Coming to the second cost on the category of fixed cost, there is interest. Generally, the interest operator might buy the machine with borrowing the money, or when you buy a machine taking the loan from the banks or etc., then sometimes the tax has to be, the interest has to be paid to the bank. Therefore, the interest has to be taken. So interest is the fixed cost. Whether you use the machine or not, you have to pay the interest for the purchased price. Therefore, the interest can be calculated as P is the purchase price, S is the salvage value divided to into I is the interest rate. So I is the annual interest rate charged, it's rupees per year, and P is the purchase price in rupees. S is the salvage value, which is 10% of the purchase price. I is the interest rate in fraction in this case, or percentage, then I by 100 will be there. Therefore, the PS, this is rupees per year and this is rupees per hour. Either you can calculate, just divide by a number of hours to be used, average annually, you can say. So you can calculate the interest rate, interest part of the fixed cost, that is can be calculated. So it is the working hour per year. Coming to the insurance and tax, generally insurance tax is taken as 1% of the purchase price. So generally it is taken per year. So from here actually you can calculate either 1% of cost divided by useful life year hour per year. So you can calculate per hour insurance tax under the category of fixed cost. Also housing and shelter, we need some money to construct the shelter or something like that. So therefore even if you don't use the machine, you have to use the shelter or housing or the whatever the cost. Therefore housing and shelter also takes 1% of the purchase price. So here also 1% of purchase price per year. So from here actually you can calculate and which can be added to the fixed cost. Therefore the fixed total fixed cost under the or ownership cost will be equal to depreciation cost either per year or per hour, interest rate interest cost per year or hour, insurance and taxes and housing and shelter can be added together so that you can calculate the total fixed cost. Coming to the variable cost or operating cost, first is the repair and maintenance. So any machine needs some operation, repair and maintenance after some hour of operation. Therefore, when you operate the machine, you have to repair and maintenance cost has to be paid. And therefore, repair maintenance generally used generally 5 to 10% of the purchase price per year. So generally 5 to 10% of purchase price per year. There is used as a repair and maintenance cost. Then coming to the fuel cost. Generally fuel cost is the most important cost for the machineries where actually it is run by the engine. So fuel cost generally calculated as latest average fuel consumption if it is known, that is liter per hour by the machine. Then it can be also calculated, if it is not known then it's 0.2 into P for diesel engine. For if it is run by diesel engine, then you can calculate the average fuel consumption per that is liter per hour, can be if P is known, that is the rated power or drawbar power of the machine. For a petrol engine it's little high, because petrol engines are little less efficient than diesel engine. So coming to the fuel cost, the fuel cost can be calculated as the average fuel consumption, from where you can calculate from this formula, if it is not known or it is given, then you can just calculate into the working time in a year. So you can calculate how much hour you are using into the cost of the fuel per liter. If it's the current price, whatever the market price will be there, then you can calculate the total fuel cost per year or hour. Either it's a year or hour, you can calculate. So in this case, liter per hour it is there. So you will multiply by hour. If you add year, then cost of fuel per liter can be calculated. Next is the oil cost. Generally, the oil cost is around 15 to 20%, or sometimes it's 20 to 30% of fuel cost. Generally, you have to add 20% to 30% of fuel cost. So you have to add to the variable cost or operating cost. Next cost is the wages or labor cost, because the machines or tractor has to be operated by some laborers or operator. You have to pay the wage to the labor. So generally, the machine is run by depends on the machine. So number of laborers can be calculated. If it's a multi-labor machine, then you have to take the two laborers or three laborers according to the requirement, and you have to calculate for on the basis of hours or day or per year actually. So generally, the labor cost depends on the particular machine on the daily basis. Generally, if you don't know, then you can per hour you can calculate, and on the flat basis, 50 rupees per hour is taken. Next is the total cost. Total variable cost will be equal to repair and maintenance cost plus fuel cost plus oil cost and plus wage of labor, wage or labor cost. So you have to add all the costs to calculate the total variable cost or operating cost. Therefore, after knowing that, total cost of the machine operation can be calculated as total fixed cost plus total variable cost. So two categories, under two categories, whatever the cost will come, then we can calculate the total cost of operation for the particular machine. So implement cost and tractor cost can be calculated separately, and they can added up if there will be tractor and implement combination will be there. For implement cost, generally the fuel cost, lubrication cost and labor cost, or this is lubrication means oil cost, can be excluded. So because these are not included in the implement does not use fuel, lubrication or labor. Generally it's with the tractor. Therefore this is the only key things you have to, when you want to calculate the cost of the machine and implements. So let us take an example to find out how do the costs are calculated. So let us have a power tiller, a 15 HP power tiller having a purchase price of 1,50,000. So not 15,000, this is 1,50,000. So let us see, 1,50,000, 1.5 lakh, having economy life of 10 years and expected years of use is rated 500 hours. So then how to go further? First of all, you have to assume something like assumptions. First is the salvage value. Salvage value is 10%. 10% of purchase price, that is 1,50,000 rupees. So then interest rate, that is 10%, let it same. So flat. Insurance and tax, let it 1%. Shelter or housing, that is 1%. Then let us see fuel consumption, let it be 1 liter per hour. So 1 liter per hour. And lubrication cost or oil cost, let it that is rupees 150 per liter. Then lubrication consumption, let it is 5% or 10% 5% of fuel, let it 5% of fuel. So that means 1 liter in this case only 5%, this is 50 ml per hour in this case. Then 50% into, you can calculate Then repair maintenance. That is let it be 5 to 8%. Labor, let it be 50 rupees per hour. So these are the assumptions you have to do before solving the problem. Next, going to the solution part. So first of all, coming to the fixed cost, we calculate. So let it fixed cost. So then we will calculate the variable cost. First, fixed cost is depreciation. So let it depreciation. So in under depreciation, how much? That is P minus S into L. So that is P is how much? 150,000. 50,000 minus 10% of 150,000 is 15,000 divided by L is 10 years. So therefore this will be equal to 13,500 per year, rupees per year you can say. So this is the depreciation. Now second part is interest. So interest is let it be P plus S by 2 into I. So that is in this case I is 10%. So there is fraction is 10 by 100, this 0.1. So that will be equal to P is 150,000 plus 15,000 divided by 2 into 10 by 100. So that will be equal to how much? That is 8,250 rupees per year. Next is the insurance and tax. That is 1% of purchase price. That is equal to 0.01 into 1,15,000. So that will be equal to rupees 1500 per year. 1500. Then housing also 1% of purchase price, that is same as 1500 per year. These are the fixed costs. So therefore the total fixed cost will be, so total fixed cost, there is the will be equal to first one is 13,500 plus 8,250 plus 1500 plus 1500, that will be equal to, that is 24,750 rupees per year. Or also we can calculate per hour, that is 24,750 divided by 500, because we have assumed the 500 hour, so that will be equal to 49.5 per hour. So this is the fixed cost. Coming to the operating cost, let it here we'll do. So operating cost, first of all repair and maintenance, let it repair. So draw one. So repair and maintenance, that is 5%, let it 5% of purchase price, that is 0.05 into 150,000 per year. That will be equal to 7,500 per year. Then per hour also you can get. Per hour it will be 7,500 divided by 500, that will be equal to 15, so rupees 15 per hour. That is the repair cost. Coming to the fuel cost, so here it is straightforward given, that is 1 liter per hour. So let us see, total cost will be, let it 80 rupees. Now I think 70 rupees, okay, 70 plus 70 into 1, that is 70 rupees 70 per hour. So this is the cost of the fuel. Next is the lubrication. So lubrication is given 150 rupees per liter and 5% of oil. So that is 1 liter into, so this is lubrication cost, that will be equal to 1 into 0.05, that is 5%. Then 1 liter is 150 rupees, that will be equal to rupees 7.5 per hour. Next is the labor cost. Labor cost, so that will be equal to rupees 50 per hour. Therefore, total operating cost will be, so total operating cost per hour will be equal to how much? That is 7 rupees 15 plus first of all is the 15, that is the repair and maintenance cost per hour, plus 70 plus 7.5 plus, that is 50. So that will be equal to 142.5 rupees per hour. So this is the operating cost, 142.5 rupees, and fixed cost is 49.5 rupees per hour. Therefore, the total cost will be equal to, total cost will be equal to 142.5 plus 49.5, that will be equal to 192 rupees per hour. So this is the hourly cost for the power tiller. Now also you can calculate how much hour can be used for the break-even point. So break-even point, you know, so BEP or break-even point. So this much hour can be done to get the machine value, that is fixed cost, if is known. So fixed cost per year divided by, that is custom hiring, let it custom hiring is 400 rupees, which is custom hiring price, minus that is operating cost. So fixed cost is we calculated, that is how much per year. Fixed cost is total is 24,750 we have to pay per year if you are not using the machine. Therefore 400 rupees if you are you can get it from the hired basis, then you can operating cost you are you will be paying, that is 142.5 rupees per hour. So then this is the hour you can have to use, that is around 90 hours you have to use. So this is, or maybe 88 or 85 something it will come. So this is the year hours you have to use the machine so that you can get the break-even points, or that means the machine value can be you can get it if you are not using for any other purpose. So this minimum 90 hours you have to use the machine so that you can get some profit. No, not profit, at least you can pay all the loans and other things if you are purchasing. So this is called the break-even point hours. So break even point is the fixed cost per hour divided by the in current price, let it is 400 rupees is the custom hiring price if you get it from the market. So that's why you have to use it at least 90 hours. I hope you get everything. Minimum 600 hours if you use the power tiller, then you'll get a lot of profit. Otherwise 90 hours to get even. I hope you got it about the calculation of cost for the machineries and tractor. Please like and subscribe to my channel.